first round win, these coaches have to tell their kids it's one and done in this second round game between the San Diego State Aztecs and the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Bulldogs might be looking at the fight of the season tonight, Dick. Any particular keys to victory for them?
For them to win tonight, the keys are as follows. First of all, I look for the point guard to be in control of the team out there. He's got to be the leader. He's got to be the boss. He's got to be in command. Next, reward your big man. Give him the ball down low. Get him into the game. Let him be part of the offense. And lastly, be aggressive defensively and force the offense out of its rhythm.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. The small forward with the ball. And in and out.
Trying to go inside.
Looking for the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score.
Pushing that basketball.
They go into the low block. The point guard gets the pass. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal. They anticipate so well defensively.
He quickly brings it up court. Goes up for two.
My goodness, Mr. Nestler, that was phenomenal, baby. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Trying to draw the foul. Up, easy one. Our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nestler. Nice to have you along with us. Had a momentary look from three-point land. The shooting guard gets the ball. For two. Perfectly executed. The shooting guard takes the pass.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block for the bucket. They still don't score. The shooting guard takes the feed. Olsen is eager and excited to compete.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
Tries for two.
I didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Now trying to feed the low block. Number 32 with the fake. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. And we've got a whistle and a foul. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the zip. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
I love that. Trying to feed the low block. Pass down low. There's a drop step and, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Down inside. They move it into the front court.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. He takes the shot, goes in. Let's see if they go two for one here, Dick. beats the pass in the paint. Time to pick up the defense here now.
Turnover City now always really negate any offense.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Number five, pump fakes. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Robin draws the personal. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. You can't miss free throws, Dick. It's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football, special situations. You got to be able to execute there.
Makes the second shot. He's got a nice shot fake. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He throws it up from downtown. Off the rim and no good. At the end of the first half, the Bulldogs are trailing by two. Gonzaga has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turn it over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Dick, these kids have battled through a first half. They battled through an entire season and their conference tournaments, and now it's down to who's got some gas left in the tank.
I think you and I have seen over the years what separates the teams that can march on and win six in a row: the ability to handle pressure, the ability to play with poise, and be able to finish games. Instead of giving him that, use a foul.
Up fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Here's the offensive drop step on the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Drops the bucket despite the harm.
And it takes some pride on the defensive end.
With a little baby hook, the ball goes out of bounds. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Gets it to go. Dumps it in. For the bucket. And he missed. The shooting guard takes the feed.
Look at that spacing.
He pump fakes. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Basket falls despite the contact.
This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
Tries one from three-point land. Way off target. They're working around the perimeter. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you what, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Looks at a three, off the rim and no good. He intercepts it. Puts it up. Got it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Jumped in front to take it away. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stop before any further damage is done. Guys?
The Aztecs will step to the line for the first time. He misses it. Second shot is good. Timeout. Both teams will get a breather here. We'll get a chance to talk things over. We're ready to get back to the action. Dick, is 10 points safe at this point?
Are you kidding me? 10 scratches wouldn't be safe with half of this time left. Up and inside.
He dials long distance. He hits the shot. Pushes it. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Again, they look to run. Beasley receives the pass. Intercepted. He takes the three. The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
At this point in the game, clock management and execution are really important. The team that does these things well will win, I guarantee it.
Check in with Aaron, who's standing by.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. And let's go back out onto the floor. The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy at this point, Brad.
Waller receives the ball.
They need to foul here.
You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
Small forward gets the ball. Nice move with the There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense. This is a very important possession. They got to score to stay alive. They have the foul. We send them to the line and hope they miss.
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here?
Right, Brad. They have the foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
Dick, let's take a look right now at our backcourt production.
Hey, team success depends on backcourt production, Brad. If you can handle the rock, make good decisions, penetrate, and knock down the open jumper, you give yourself a great opportunity to get to the winner's circle.
Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ball game.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
Yet another foul. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnover.
I'll tell you one thing, that leads you to the exit sign. No question, you get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy, I love that. Hits the second shot. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
He unloads a three. Questionable shot selection there.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Chase goes to the line for the first time. He missed it. A less than stellar performance, I'd say, at the line tonight.
Less than stellar? You're too nice a guy, Brad. They're shooting horribly from the line tonight. Take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
It's a four-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat.
Beasley handles the pass. Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club. But, you know, you got to win it. Keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. That was the difference in the game.
The Aztecs graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.